Thanks for tuning in. Please like, subscribe, and check out my Instagram for cool science and not science stuff.
And a big thank you to my patrons on Patreon for your contributions to my channel.
Welcome back to Anatomy and Physiology on Catalyst University. My name is Kevin Tokoff. Please make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel for future videos and notifications. In this video, we're going to be looking at regular rhythms on an electrocardiogram, and we're going to be determining the heart rate by two different methods. The first method we're going to look at is what's called the 1500 method. After talking with a lot of different students, this seems to be the easier method to do. The other method we'll look at is what's called the 300 method, and instructors seem to find that method easier, so go figure. But we'll look at both of them, and we'll hopefully get roughly the same values for heart rate on the same EKG pattern. So here's my EKG pattern. Regardless of what your clinical interpretation of this is, to calculate heart rate from this, we need to know if it's regular or irregular in rhythm. And for that, we look at these RR intervals. So basically the distance between this peak and this peak. Then we look at this peak, and so on and so forth. And if all of those distances are roughly the same, then we can call it regular. Okay? So this RR distance is roughly the same as this one, which is roughly the same as this one, and so on and so forth. So this would be a regular rhythm. If some of them were longer, some were shorter, so basically inconsistent with each other, then we would call it irregular. And for irregular rhythms, we have a separate method to calculate heart rate. And so whenever I have a regular sinus rhythm, I can use either the 1500 method or the 300 method, which we'll get to in a minute. So the first step here is to figure out which peak is the best to look at. And it looks like I have seven to choose from, but I'm actually going to pick this one right here. And if you can, the best peak to use is the one that is right on one of these solid lines. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to count the number of small boxes between the peak in question, this one right here, which is in the red box, and the peak adjacent to it. Okay? So remember that from solid line to solid line, this is five small boxes. So this would be 5, 10, 15, 20, and then there's one more small box right there, so 21. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 1500, always this number, and divide by the number of small boxes that I counted. And that's going to be my heart rate in beats per minute. So I counted that there were 21 small boxes between this peak in question and the peak adjacent to it. That's my RR distance. There's 21 small boxes. So I'm simply going to take 1500 and divide it by 21. And that's going to be my heart rate in beats per minute. And I get roughly 71 beats a minute. When you do this calculation, you're going to get about 71.4. And since we can't have fractional or decimal heart rates, you just round it to the nearest whole number. So 71.4 beats per minute will be 71 beats per minute. And that's the 1500 method. So to summarize that, you find a peak that is right on one of those solid lines, and you count the number of small boxes between it and the peak adjacent to it. Usually we go forward. You can go backwards, although there's no real reason to do that, so we're usually always going to go forwards. So you get the number of small boxes, and then you take 1500, always that number, and divide by the number of small boxes, and that is your heart rate in beats per minute. The only thing with this method is that you have to have a calculator unless you're really good at mental math or long division. But seeing as most of us have phones and on the phones we have calculators, you should be able to do this anywhere, anytime. The only exception is potentially on a test where you're not given a calculator, and so that's the only disadvantage of this method. The other method that we can use on regular rhythms is what's called the 300 method. And so this is a method that does not require a calculator. It's less accurate, and it seems to be the method that's preferred by a lot of instructors. So let's actually go over how to do this. So the first thing I do is I determine if this EKG pattern is regular or irregular. Now this is the same pattern from before, so it is regular. And then we need to determine which peak is best to use. Again, we're going to look at the peak that's right on this solid line. And so this is the peak we're going to use. And of course, I have it blown up down here. Now, the first time you see this method used, it's going to seem a little bit strange. You have to do a little bit of practice with this before it becomes a little more natural. So the way this works is I start at that peak in question. And every time I go a distance of a big box over, it gets assigned a particular number. So I start here. I go one big box over, right? And it gets the number 300. I go a second big box over, it gets the number 150. I go a third big box over, it gets the number 100. A fourth big box over, 75. A fifth big box over, 60. A sixth big box over, 50. Some people just choose to memorize those numbers, 300, 150, 100, 75, 60, 50. But if you do happen to forget, those numbers basically come from this formula, 300 over x. So each successive large box over is given by 300 over x. In other words, if I go over one big box over, it's 300 over 1, 300. If I go over two big boxes, it's 300 over 2, 150. If I go over a third big box, it's 300 over 3, 100. And you can do this over and over again. 300 over 4 is 75, 300 over 5 is 60, 300 over 6 is 50. If you had to go further, you could do 300 over 7. I don't know what that is off the top of my head, but you can keep on going if need be. That would be a very slow heart rate. So really all you do here is you look at this adjacent peak, which is actually this one up here in the picture, and you just look to see what numbers it's between. Well, this peak is clearly between 60 beats per minute and 75 beats per minute. That's all you can really say, definitively. It's really just an estimation technique. Now, beyond giving a range of heart rates like this, we can get a little more of an educated guess and maybe give a specific number. Well, we know that the heart rate's between 60 and 75 beats a minute. The peak here is a little bit closer to 75, so maybe we'll say the heart rate's about 70 beats per minute. This method is nothing more than an approximation. It's not as accurate as the 1500 method, but the nice thing is it doesn't require a calculator. However, that being said, we should still get something similar to what we got in the 1500 method because it's the same EKG pattern. So in the 300 method, we estimated about 70 beats per minute. In the 1500 method, we got 71 beats a minute, which is very, very close. So hopefully this video gave you a good understanding of two methods here to calculate the heart rate given a regular EKG pattern. In the next video, we're going to look at how we deal with an irregular EKG rhythm. Please make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel for future videos and notifications. Thank you.